Somebody who started their education at Duke Ellington High School of the Performing Arts in Washington, D.C. has got something going on, and it's just gone on from there. As she has traveled the world with the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra, she'll be doing it again come the holiday season. Please put your hands together for what is an incredible band, by the way. Kofi Abel on the drums. Nazir Hunter, the master of the congas. That's right. Kofi Abel is on the congas. Nazir Hunter on the drums, everyone. Russell Hall on bass. Young swingmaster Luther Allison at the piano. And please give a very warm welcome to the lady who is making her Charlie Parker Jazz Festival debut, Ekep Nkwele.
The power of love. The power of love. Plan, peace and happiness for every day. let's go. The power of love, the power of love, the power of love, the power. I can't hear you say the power of love, the power of love, the power of love, the power. I can feel it all over. The power of love, the power of love, the power of love, the power. I can feel it all over. The power of love, the power of love, the power of love, the power. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. New York, y'all feeling the power of love this afternoon? Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday. You are blessed, you are highly favored, and you are here to see some good damn music, okay? Thank you so much for joining us. I don't have much time, so unlike the way I normally do, I won't do too much talking. That's bad news for me, good news for you. So we're gonna move this right on along. What's our next song, Luther? Okay, that's a good one. That's a good one. All right, so if you know anything about me, you would know that a woman that I discovered and grew an affinity to, fairly recently, her name is Abby Lincoln. And yes, absolutely, absolutely. Her music, her message, her voice, her gift has inspired me to be this person that you see here today. I wasn't always that person, but moving forward, I plan to just be a better and better and better version of this person that her music has inspired me to be. And so we're going to do an arrangement of her song, her original song, Caged Bird. The first.
Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows fall? Why should my heart feel lonely and long for heaven and home? When Jesus is my portion, constant friend is he. He's a watches me.
Is that all right?
So I sing.
Thank you. Thank you. This is Africa by John Coltrane, arranged by Abby Lincoln. Took a trip to Paris, saw the Eiffel Tower, flew to Honolulu, South Pacific Flower, traveled way to Burma, crossed the Bay of Bengal, went to Old Malaya. Thank you.
Me to a certain part in my set where I'm just gonna need strength, because I want to honor one of my late mentors. I called him my unk. He called me either kneecap, which I guess it kind of sounds like a cap, but not really, but to him it was enough. Or he called me his young warrior. And so I want to pay tribute to the late Russell Malone. The last time we performed together was last month. We toured in Spain with Cyrus Chestnut, Willie Jones III, and Daryl Hall. And there was a duet that we would do each night. We did Duke Ellington's Come Sunday. And there's something so special and intimate about voice and guitar. So today, Luther and I are gonna honor his memory and perform a duet of Come Sunday.
sky.
Next one. So when I was in high school, I first heard Nina Simone's Four Women. And it changed my life. And so I wrote a poem at that same time entitled Blackness. And I said, you know what? This song is so powerful. that I want to have Nina Simone's, some part of her spirit, some part of her legacy, a part of this poem. And so I decided to tether the riff that you hear in Four Women along with this poem that I put to melody. And here is Blackness.
Oh,
Ladies and gentlemen, please, please put your hands together. The incomparable Lewis Hayes. Abraham Burton on tenor saxophone. David Hazeltine at the piano. Desmond Douglas on bass. And Nina and Steve Nelson on the vibraphone. The Lewis Hayes Quintet. Remember, their newest album is Art Form Revisited. Please look for it online. Do we have record stores anymore, guys? Are record stores still a thing? All right. How's it? Now, to dispense a groove. I'm very excited because though I've seen this man perform numerous times, I have never seen him perform in this setting. So please put your hands together for, all the way from Greensboro, North Carolina, Charlie Hunter. And of course, when one is truly hip, you never travel without your horns. The Hunter Tone Horns. And blessing us with his presence, all the way from the second city, the windy city of Chicago, please welcome back home the one, the only Kurt Elling. Super Blue.
I know he'll never be forgotten. He was a king on ground. I know I'll always remember the warmth of his sound. It lingers so long, I'm sure he's still around. For those who heard, they repeat him yet. So those who hear won't forget. The sound of each phrase echoes a time uncountable by days. The things he played are with us now, and they'll endure should time allow. Oh yeah, I remember Russell. Somehow I always hear him play, somehow, every day. I hear his lovely tone in every guitar sound that has a beauty all its own. So how can we say someone so real has really gone away? I hear him now. I always will. Believe me, I hear Russell Malone still.
Listen to the singer. Never swear, say a prayer.
potion chain, that's a rule. So keep it loose, I'm adding over the loose. A thousand hours on a thousand years, taking the crown, I'm coming down. See, it's the baddest around. She's mixing simply amazing. She's going through. We'll be right back. and beautiful. Thank you for staying around. Goodness gracious, you've heard a lot of notes. You ready for a couple of more?
Yeah.
Come on. I've got a wandering feeling that it's time for moving on. Time's up on the clock that's on the wall of telling me that I've been standing still for much too long. My picture's always blank before it's drawn. Night is dark, it's just before the dawn. So you bring them tender breeze and I can provide the brawn. Oh, oh, I've got a vintage Ford Falcon that is hungry for the road. When the night falls and stars in the sparkling dims, and don't you know that God is blue there, holding out her honey paws to all of us the way out there. And when the spirit calls, both of us are lifted up in the open room for that mezcal and sings flavored air. Don't say I never told it. home to get the job done, but I promise you it shall be a lot more fun. Two holy fools is always better than one. I mean, speaking of the sun, we've had God's beautiful, glorious golden sky draping all over us all afternoon, listening to jazz music, the finest music that could possibly be created, and therefore divine. Making a family reunion backstage out of all the jazz family that shows up. That's right, I said family, because once you're in the jazz family, you become more than that. You're up in there. You're making it. It's all part of it. You're uncle to somebody, aunt to somebody, nephew to somebody. Maybe you're somebody's son. Maybe it's going to be like that. I don't know. My point out here is, even though it's the beautiful possibilities that are all coming true at a time when you least expect it, or maybe some of you expected it, which is why you made a conscious choice to be here, and you weren't just dragged here by your friend. I'm talking about that other guy. I'm talking about the guy who got his car keyed or something like that. Or maybe he just saw his ex-wife walking down the street. Or maybe he tripped over a pothole, hurt himself on something. Maybe it's a recurring injury. I don't know. Age is a bitch. Maybe it's just a knee that goes wrong for no apparent reason. It's not your fault. It's just what happens to people. It's just a part of us. We're walking down the street one day, we're feeling like we're all fit and trim and God's gift to somebody. And the next thing you know, you're tripping all over yourself, making a fool of yourself. Can't remember your words, speaking in another language that nobody else can speak. It's not your fault. It's what we gotta get over. It's just who we are. They put these things in our way, man. Just because, then we gotta figure out how to lift ourselves up, how to get ourselves out of it, how to get ourselves climbed out of that hole. We gotta pull each other up. We gotta be a part of the answer. That's who we are. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I say. You can't always see it, but it's always there. You might forget to feed it, but then you say it feels unfair. But it ain't just disappear, because it's always in the air. And just because you ain't awake, it don't mean you ain't aware. So listen up, cause the deepest truth ain't written in no book. They're all around you all the time, but you use your heart to look. They may be in a candy bar, they may be in a baby group that brings back the lost, that I've long lost you. Or in a photograph of a long lost stare that somehow leaves you shook. They're in the starry children's hair and a hundred smoky smell. They're in a breath when the story is gone while I'm ringing up a bell. But they're always there like Manitoba. And for the little princess, the landlord's children are going down. Because the truth always comes to me. It's dark, and we're wearing sunglasses. Oh, Holding it down on drums. How about a hand for Charlie Hunter? Oh, we are so happy. So blessed, so undeservedly so. Here we are. Oh, it's the best time of day. It's the golden hour. And we get to share it with you. I'm excited. Not only because of all the music we get to make, but because there's always but that potential of a little bit of, I don't know, enlightenment somewhere along the way for me. Not like I'm gonna be the guy gonna bring it, unless I'm quoting somebody else. I'm talking about me trying to find my way through life, trying to figure out what my thing is supposed to be, so that I do every show a little bit better than the last one. I sing a little bit more in tune, I can hit it a little harder, I can play something I never played before. That's the jazz way. We're trying to find it, I'm trying to find it up here. But there are immutable truths that cannot be touched or untouched. They just exist. They pre-exist all of us. They pre-exist all the bugs and roaches running around in your basement. They pre-exist the lawn that you're stepping out on. They pre-exist the invention and discovery of electricity. I don't know whether it was invented or discovered. I think that was pre-existing too. But I'm just rambling on here, and I'm not running for office. I'm trying to get to a point. I got something serious to talk about. Like math. Specifically. The number 9, and how I never could get a hold of it. I mean, in third grade, I could not get it happening. Man, I could do the 2s, jam, 3, a little awkward, but maybe with practice. 4, multiple of 2, woo! 5, yes sir, 5, you can just keep on rolling with number 5. Number 6 was a little more obstreperous, and 7 was not going to happen anytime soon. Thankfully, though, the dear departed Bob Dureau came across with a little bit of sequence of how young people could learn their multiplication tables, and ABC television pretended that they were going to do a public service and put this stuff out in between Bugs and Roadrunner, that kind of a thing, so that on Saturday morning they could pretend they were hooking us up. And in a way, they were, and here we are. So thanks to them, but mostly thanks to Bob Dureau, because he made this shit happen. And it goes down like this. Now, any of you who need it, you can bring your calculators out and find out if I'm right when I say number 9 will put you on the spot. number 9. We'll tie you up in a knot. So when you're trying, multiplying by 9, you might give it everything you've got and still be stuck. Multiplying by 9 is that it's 1 less than 10. You see, 9 is the same as 10 minus 1, so you could multiply your number by 10. Then subtract the number from the result, and you get the same product as if you multiplied by 9.
And you knew what you were doing.
I mean, 8 times 9 is 80 minus 8. 7 times 9 is 70 minus 7. And 6 times 9 is 60 minus 6. Could use those tricks. But you must have some secret when you can't step on, or you break your mental. Call me number 9. Of course, it doesn't hurt to know the times, tables, and nines by heart. I believe they go like this. 9 is 18. 3 times 9 is 27. 4 times 9 is 36.
Oh!
There's a 56-year-old man finally getting his shit together. 5 times 9 is 45. 6 times 9 is 54. And 7 times 9. This hybrid in third grade can understand it. I don't believe it really actually existed. You know what I'm talking about? Cause you must have some secret when you can't beat it, or else you'll beat it with naughty, nasty, mean old number 9. The whole COVID thing happened. This, what you're listening to tonight, if you like it, well, you can think of it as a silver lining, a small, tiny bit of silver lining to come out of COVID. You see, everybody remembers what it was like. We were all shut in. We were here in town ringing bells and trying to make everybody, I don't know, feel peaceful from a distance. Somehow, one way or another, Charlie gave me a call in the middle of it. He said, "Kurt, I think it's time we make a record." I said, "How can we do that? We can't be in the same studio. How are we even going to get into the same state? We can't drive across state." He said, "Do you realize it's the 21st century? We have the technology. We can do things little different, yellow better, bigger, faster, badder, bolder, possible, maybe, shall we?" And so, he sent me a bunch of tracks. They were all groovy. They had all of this up in there. Ooh, something's missing though. They had all of this up in there. What was missing? That part was missing. That part. Let's see when that comes around again, because I was feeling very tragical at the time, as many of us were, I'm sure, people of good sense. There it is now. It's going to pass around a couple of times. They put that in there, is my point. That beautiful buttery tummy rub thing that you just need at times like that. When you just a little. Just a, try that in your chair. If you're sitting down just trying to, nobody's got to know. It feels so good. It just makes smiling face. Ah, yes. Oh, Yes, yes, people. That's where we put it. So they put that in that they sent them over to me, and all these beautiful tracks, and I had to figure out what I was gonna do to them. I called up to Charlie and I said, man, this is all great and everything. There's no melody up on here. You sent me tracks, there's no melody. He said, that's your job, Dad. He said, you get up out of that bourbon bathtub you've been soaking in. Get your pencil dry. Start to writing. That's what we need you for now. I said, yeah. So I got it happening. We put a thing out. Super Blue won. Ooh, Super Blue won. And now we have Super Blue 2, the Iridescent Spree, which is exciting. We got an EP coming out. Oh, I love it. Just does it every time for me. Here's my point. What's my point? Well, we made it so we could feel better. That's it. Maybe it'll help you feel better too. We're gonna give it to you what we got. Uh-oh. I feel something coming on.
I feel a song coming on.
Girl, don't act so manic. I promise you we're gonna be fine. Ain't no need to panic. I'm telling you we'll get our chance to shine. We've been out playing this music now for about 500 years, all in 1 year. We played about 1,000 dates in one night. That's how we do. I can't bring home the bacon otherwise. There's no bacon. I have no passive income. I need to sing for every note, which is why I'm here tonight. No, it's not. It's because I love you. Here's what we're going to do. We need to have the resonance of the entire room come back to us. This is not a one-way street. This is a roundabout. It's a spiritual roundabout. So here's everybody. I see you. Don't pretend I can't. And I see you behind that tree limb, too. So here's what you're going to do. Everybody over here, right up to about this spot right here, and you're going to sing for me. You say, yo, whoa, ladies, whoa, whoa. Come on, choir. Oh, you're sounding good already. It's going to be a competition. Keep it going. Everybody in this whole middle section, all the way to the back, say, you say, yo, whoa. Oh, yes. Yes, choir. Oh, guess where you're going to put it? your hands in the air. Look at that jazz people doing this shit. It's beautiful. Keep it going. You say, no woman, no cry. No woman, no cry. Listen, little sister, don't you shed no tear. No, 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 belongs to him. It was in 1952 in a little sub-basement under a office building somewhere. He was by himself. Nobody actually heard it. Nobody actually recorded it. But it came to me in a dream when I was listening to the radio and a great band called The Roots were playing it, and I thought, wow, that just sounds just like Bird to me. And it doesn't sound anything like Bird, but God bless Bird, and Bird is the word, and he always will be. We love him, we love you, and we love to hit it. I'm not loving back. I said, and what you
Oh,
some time. We thank you so much for inviting us into your park. We thank you so much for staying up a little bit longer to enjoy the golden hour with us. We hope we've made it a little bit happier for you. You've made it a joy for us. We're so grateful to you all for making the scene. How about a hand for this atomic horn section over here? We're talking about a gentleman playing on the trombone, that big long sliding thing, Dr. Chris Ops. The man with the brand new Parallax for shoes, he's here for the first day of school. I'm talking about your friend and mine playing tenor saxophone, Mr. Dan White. And look at this, he needs no introduction, so I ain't gonna give him none, because you already know the sound, you know the vibe, you know the feel, you know where it's coming from the heart, it's coming from the head, it's coming from all the way down. Beneath the toes, it's your friend and mine, Dr. Kenyatta Beasley, playing trumpet. And how about this young fella? Here's a stallion playing the Rhodes keyboard instrument, and the Rhodes keyboard instrument, and the Nord Electro 5B KMG 365, in all of its red, white, and black opalescence. But it doesn't mean a thing without a genius at the helm, controlling the keys, making them do what they want to do, making them sing the way that they want to sing. He's a young stallion on his way up. He comes from Bogota, Colombia, but he's here with us in New York City tonight, Dr. Julius Rodriguez. So happy to have him with us once again, because when he lays that groove down, it stays lean. He's the man with the plan, the master of the blaster of disaster. He's bringing it to you in 3D, 4D, 5D, one big giant kick up the you-know-what. And I'll tell you why, because he's doing it with love, coming to you all the way from... I can't read my writing no more. Let's just call it where it's really from. Bringing it to you, the Memphis beat from Memphis, Tennessee. Your friend and mine, Mr. Marcus Sticks Finney. And these two fellas. How do you do that, kid? Only six strings. Two electrical outlets, one solid body guitar. Woo! And a brand new hat he bought over in Tokyo, Japan. He's a fan. He's a Tokyo man. Fan man from Japan. He's bringing it to you as only he can. I bring you the proud son of Rorschach, California. And your friend and mine, Mr. Charlie Hunter. Thanks to you all. Thanks so much to the genius of Charlie Parker and the Charlie Parker Jazz Festival. We love you. We hope we get to hit for you again sometime very soon. It's been a dream. It's been a dream. It's been as real as it gets, but it's been a dream. My name is Kurt Allen. God bless you. Take care of each other until we meet again. Good night. I push my seeds on my deep in the tip. I push it, make it, close, I'm thinking my tip.
ladies and gentlemen. Come on, keep your hands together and stay on your feet. Super Blue! Charlie Hunter, Kurt Elling, the Hunter Tone Horns. Are you sure the name of this band's not Super Power? Because that's what it sounded like to me. Wow. I can't imagine a more powerhouse way to close out this festival than with what we just heard. Thank you, City Parks Foundation. Thank you, Summer Stage. Special thanks to all of you for coming. And I do want to leave you with this. As Kurt Elling and I were catching up backstage, we were talking about our mutual friend, Russell Malone, to whom this entire festival really has been dedicated this weekend. And he brought up something important, and I echoed it. Namely, that what Russell always did is he called his family and he called his friends. And when he was done talking, he always told them that he loved them. So take my advice and emulate Russell Malone. Call your family, call your friends, and when you're done talking, tell them you love them. And have a great rest of the summer, everyone.